It's a great time to be playing around with battle royales. In the last 2 years alone, the genre has drawn numbers that run into millions. From AAA game developers to studios that you haven't even heard of, they're all jumping on the battle royale bandwagon. In this week's Mobile Gaming Corner, we're diving into Free Fire Battlegrounds, a multiplayer battle royale by Vietnam-based indie studio 111 Dots and publisher Garena Studios. Typical to any battle royale format you're familiar with, Free Fire Battlegrounds works along the same premise. The first difference here is, it's 50 players jumping off the plane and not 100. It's still the same drill afterwards. Choose a good landing zone, scavenge for weapons, armor and utility items, fight to reach the coveted last man standing by defeating 49 others. Now that we got that out of the way, let's see how different it is compared to the other games in the genre. First, Free Fire Battlegrounds prioritizes performance, which means that low to mid-end Android smartphones can have a smooth gameplay experience without them heating up. This also helps in battery conservation, but you get less of the graphics and textures compared to the others. Second, you play Free Fire Battlegrounds by choosing a character from a roster of 26 others, each with their own unique skills, looks, and perks. In the beginning, you get two characters unlocked with options to customize their clothing and skin color. The rest are made available to you as you progress through the levels, or you can purchase them from the in-game store. Third, you jump out of a plane with 49 others. This could possibly be the reason why the game runs so smoothly on lower-end smartphones. Less number of players in the sandbox, less reason for heavy performance requirements to render the game. Fourth, while you do have vehicles in the game, it's not a whole bunch of them. You have cars, ships, motorcycles to choose from to navigate through the map. Fifth, Free Fire Battlegrounds has a bunch of interesting maps and modes to play around with. You can play solos, duos, or even a squad of four. There is also a training mode for you to test out new weapons and characters. Sixth, similar to others in the genre, Free Fire Battlegrounds run events constantly with their gameplay standing out and enough content to entertain, plus the rewards. The gameplay interface and UI makes for less cluttered space while you're in a session, which you can of course tweak it around from the settings screen, but overall I felt Free Fire Battlegrounds was cleaner in its representation but lacked in some aspects. With regards to in-game transactions and economy, there is an in-game currency, and you can buy the same for anywhere between 10 rupees to 9,000 rupees. Free Fire Battlegrounds is available to download for free on Play and iOS stores. If there are any of you who play Free Fire, we'd love to know what you think about the game. That's all we have for this week's Mobile Gaming Corner. For all things video games and pop culture, don't forget IGN India.